Well, hello, and welcome to Below the Rim. Pablo goes ISO, solo. Sounds a bit weird. Many of you haven't seen my face. Gutted. Here it is. Right, we're gonna try and occupy people's minds for 10, 15 minutes, maybe more, depending on how things unfold. But I've got a series of things we can get through, all basketball related, of course. I've got old BBL programs. Granted, a lot of them are Bears programs, but we can look at the away team. Yeah, that keep people happy. We got that. I've got hundreds of old basketball, British basketball magazines, newspapers, that kind of thing. We may do an article from time to time, probably not daily, but maybe daily. But this idea is stolen from the guys that used to do the Starters, now do the No Dunks podcast. They take a pack of old basketball cards and open them live for everyone to see. It's easy, isn't it? Right. And we've got, I just so happen to have, which I had ages ago and I haven't finished opening them. As you can see there, Topps Stadium Club 1992 to 93 Series 1 Super Premium. High definition technology. Look at that. Even back then. High def. Incidentally, did you ever hired a VCR video from a video shop, Blockbuster, before DVDs? Oh, well, actually, about the time DVDs came out, because you used to get an advert on your video before you got all the trailers, before you watched your movie, and the advert would show, it would come up and it would say, "This is your VCR," and you'd get a picture and it'd be an action scene that they'd either made up or it was whatever, cut from a film, whatever. It was an action film, and it was all grainy and horrible, and you'd look at that, and then it would split the screen, and it'd say, "This is what it will look like on DVD," and it'd show you a clearer picture on the other side, both being played on a VCR. So, kind of ridiculous. Anyway, if you're old enough to remember that, tweet us. So this is what we're going for. And I've got loads of packs left, as you can see. I've only opened a few. We're going to do a live opening right here, right now. My NBA knowledge isn't brilliant, so forgive me. Hit us up in the comments or the Twitter, wherever this goes out, YouTube, Twitter, wherever. And I'm opening it live. Let us know what an idiot I am for not knowing somebody obscure. Okay. Well, what they've done tactically is put the back of each card. So you've got to get to the, you've got to find the middle. What do you get in the middle? What's the surprise? Oh, the surprise in the middle is full membership. Can you see that? Membership club. I wonder what'd happen if I sent off. Please enclose a check for money of $29.95 in dollars. Splendid. We won't be doing that. Could be interesting. Right, let's get things started straight away. I don't have a clue who it is. Lakers player, according to this. Of course, he was 92-93 season. That's all I've got. He is a guard. It is Mr. Tony Smith. There you go. Look at the tint. It's got little gold strips at the bottom. Isn't that good? What we got on the back? On the back, we have his rookie card. Also a Topps card. Shows you the rookie card on the back there. Not quite sure why. We've got a number of stats. Let's have a look. Oh, so it's got a rating out of 5. Ball handling, 4.1. Floor leadership, 3.6. Shooting range, 3.8 out of 5. Not bad. Defense, 4.2. And his key stat, he holds Marquette's all-time single-season record for points. 689 in a season. 23.8 points per game. Set in 89-90. Well done. That's number one. I'll maybe have to find a way of adding them to my amoeba little display there. Limited. Worthing Bears scarf just under there. Just fans of the show will know that I... maybe they don't know. It'd be funny if they didn't. Yeah, Bears fan. And Raiders, obviously, because now there's no Bears, but there we are. Anyway, right, let's move on. I recognise the name. Sacramento Kings. I nearly said Kingston Kings because of the Kings jersey. Sacramento Kings, number 22. He is a forward, Lionel Simmons. Again, hit us up if you know these people. He looks a little bit like Anthony Hardaway. Number 22, shiny gold. He again has his rookie card pictured on the back there. When was he a rookie then? This season, apparently. Ooh. Maybe had a tough paper round. Right, ball handling, 3.8. Running the court, 4.0. Maybe they get a different stat. Shooting range, 3.7. Defense, 4.1. His key stat is he led all NBA small forwards in blocked shots with 132. I'm guessing that stat is based on last season. Yeah, it is. That which would have been 91-92. Next card, which I've dropped. That's not a trick. I dropped it, genuinely. Oh, God. Oh, yeah. Heavy hitter. Should have been a boxer by the looks of this. Philadelphia 76ers classic jersey he's got on there. He looks exhausted in his picture. And slightly elderly, I've got to be honest. But he's rocking a flat top. It's Jeff Rulland. I don't know if you can... Look at that flat top. Look at that. You could put a spirit level on that. That's incredible. So Jeff Rulland is obviously a centre. He's a big lad. His first out of five stat... Okay, so I'm guessing he didn't have a lot of range. His first stat is intimidation, 4.2. Mobility, 3.0. Shooting range, 3.4. And defence, 3.3. His key stat, this would be a good one. Third among active players in career field goal percent. Didn't take a lot of shots then. 0.564, 56% from the floor. Well done him. That's good. Again, another player I don't know. Oh, we've got a cracking one after that, though, I've just seen. Golden State Warriors, when they were obviously not great, I don't think. I'm just trying to think if I recognise this guy. No, not at all. He's a forward. It's a decent card. There's a nice shot of him shooting. It's Tom Tolbert. People might remember this dude. Who knows? He has intimidation, which is not doesn't bode well, does it, if your stats are... We'll see if there's a pattern emerging. There is slightly. Intimidation, 3.5. Mobility, 4.0. Shooting range, 4.0. He can put the ball up then. Defense, 3.6. His key stat... Blimey, that's a big one. After being cut and re-signed in 1989-90, he wound up as a Warrior. He rounded up as their second rebounder with 5.2 rebounds per game and seventh in scoring, 8.8 per game. One of the NBA's most colourful personalities. I don't remember this dude at all. Anyway, he had 27 points and 15 rebounds in a number of games in the 90s. Well done. I probably should know that dude. I definitely know this one. Once referred to by Bill Murray as not being white, being clear. He was in that very same film that he was quoted in. Those of you who remember Space Jam, the original one. Because the second one obviously is on its way out. Boston Celtic for life, of course, is Larry Bird. And I'm taking offers for this one. So I know my main man Daz, a bit of a Lakers fan. There you go, there's the gold at the bottom as well. Larry has a series of pictures on the back of his card. I'm not sure what each one's referring to be honest. I can't be bothered to read them either. Boston Celtics, his rookie card was 1980, of course. Which was... I'm sure that's 1980. Yeah, for those of you who will remember, there was another Bird that was also in this draft class and also got drafted for the Boston Celtics but got injured in training camp. It is, of course, Mr. Alton Bird. BBL legend. Right, what we got? Ball handling, 4.6. Running the court, 3.2. Shooting range, 4.7 out of 5. Defense, 3.5. He was a good defender. His key stats, 11, 11, 10, 15, and 8. His all-time NBA rankings in points scored. Average, field goals, assists, and steals. Oh, wow. Okay, so he's up there. One of the best and most charismatic players in the game. 11 all-star and three-time NBA MVP. That was in a row as well. If he wasn't injured, he'd be in the discussion a lot more up there with Mr. Jordan, Mr. Bryant, Mr. LeBron James. I didn't mean to pull that face. He's very good. The next one's a good one. Houston Rockets. What's this, 92, 93? So the season after this and the season after that, this dude won NBA titles with the Houston Rockets, of course, because they filled the gap while Mr. Jordan had a break. Decent outside shooter from what I remember. Bit hardcore, had a reputation for going a bit crazy. It is Vernon Maxwell. Decent card, that one. I like that one. A rookie card, 92-93 as well. His ball handling, 4. Running the court, 4.6. Shooting range, 4.7. And defense, 4.3. Because I can remember him on NBA Live 95, get the ball to Vernon Maxwell and jack up a 3. That was the... Hit more 3-pointers than 10 entire teams in the season. Just got to read that again. Hit more 3-pointers than 10 entire teams on his own. I knew he could put up a 3. Oh, this guy. I vaguely remember this guy. Dallas Mavericks. I'm not sure what other teams he played for. I don't think he just played for Dallas Mavericks, but it's big man. Forward, Doug Smith. It's old Dougie Smith there. Look, there he is. Intimidation, 3.6. Mobility, 4.5. Yeah, agile forward then. Shooting range, 2.5. Defense, 3.4. Key stat. His rebounding average of 5.1 per game was 5th best among the 91 and 92 rookies. There you go. Next one, a Laker. Oh, there's a name. I'm pretty sure this dude lifted some silverware. Maybe not, actually. I'm pretty sure he was in the finals. Jordan's first finals. Lakers Bulls. Maybe not. Maybe I'm wrong. But the name definitely rings a bell, and it is Eldon Campbell. That's a heck of a shot, isn't it? Look at that. Getting ready for the game. Intimidation, 4.7. He's a forward slash center. So that's mobility, 4.2. Shooting range, 3.1. Defense, 4. 8th in NBA with 4.07 block shots per 48 minutes. There you go. Right, let's rattle through these last ones. Don't know this one. 76er. Kenny Payne. There he is. He looks happy, doesn't he? Chuffed a bit to have a card. Ball handling, 3.2. Running the court, 4. Shooting range, 4.5. And defense, 4. Key stat. Broke Louisville record by Cannon. 44.3% of his 3-point attempts in 88-89. Decent outside shooter then. Another one I'm not sure about. Phoenix Suns. Intently defending Scott Skiles, by the looks of it. Scott Skiles at the Magic at this point. It's Nigel Knight. Or some weird spelling of Nigel, maybe. I'm not sure. A guard, obviously. That's why he's playing defense on Scott Skiles there. Ball handling, 4.5. Floor leadership, 4.2. Shooting range, 4.1. And defense, 4.1. That's not bad, is it? He's a bit of a player. Average 23.6 points per game and 11 averages in, what's that? Live game starting role with Kevin Johnson. Oh, with Kevin Johnson hurt. I see. So he was moved to the starting spot when KJ got hurt in April 1991. So he had some decent stats there. 23.6 points per game and 11 assists per game. Decent fantasy stuff for that. Another one who was part of the Larry Grandma Johnson squad with Alonzo Mourning. It's Kenny Gattison. Looks like he's putting the ball up on Kevin Willis there for the Atlanta Hawks. There he is. Full stretch. Can't really see his face. It's not, maybe not a great card. Intimidation, 4.6. Mobility, 4.5. Shooting range, 3.4. And defense, 4. His key stat. Started 71 games in 91-92 after starting just 6 games in the previous 2 seasons. Wow. Sorry. Next up. Misread it. Thought it was artist, but it's not. Philadelphia 76ers. Armand Gilliam, forward. There's his card. A decent card. I like that. Great jersey. Love the retro jerseys. Awesome. Intimidation 3.3. He's a big man, of course. Mobility 4.1. Shooting range 3.8. Defense 3.3. Key stat, established career highs in points, rebounds, assists, and block shots in 91-92. Doesn't tell you what they are, but Someone from the NBA studios right now. I like this one. I'm trying to work out who he's shooting the ball over. He's got a heavily strapped knee. If you ever watch, he's one of the ones in the studio on TNT with Shaq and the guys. It's not Charles Barkley. It is the Jet, Kenny Smith. Look at that shot. Look at that. That's good form, that one. Heavily strapped knee. If you see him walking around now, his knees just go in. It looks painful when he's jogging around. Ball handling 4.3, floor leadership 3.5, shooting range 4.3, defense 3.3. His key stat, set career highs in three-pointers with 54 and three-point percentage with 39%, which is the 13th best in the NBA. That would be the previous season. Lifting trophies, that dude. Next up, this is the worst card I've ever seen. It's a Nick. A big, strong Nick of the 90s. There was a few of them. A bruiser. No, not Charles Oakley. It's Anthony Mason. Although, without the name, maybe you wouldn't be able to get it. Because you can't see his face. What a shot. What a choice. Maybe the guy who did this was a Bulls fan. That's cracking, that. And even his card, it's got a picture of his rookie card on the back. And on that, it's side on. You still can't see his face. You can't see it anyway on there, but never mind. Anthony Mason. What stats have we got for Anthony Mason? 4.4 for intimidation. I'd give him a 5. 4.6 for mobility. 3.5 for shooting range. 4.1 for defense. Key stat. He averaged 20.9 points per game and 14.8 rebounds per game in one particular CBA season. They're giving him CBA stats. Surely he's got better stats than that in the NBA. Not better than the numbers wise, but he'll have some decent ones. That was in 1990-91. Second to last card. This is the last card now. It's someone in his warm-ups. Oh, it's... No, is that the same one? Well, help me out, people. He's at the Timberwolves in this one, looking pretty young, but I'm pretty sure he had a pretty long, or a relatively long career. It's Doug West. Not a bad one, that. He looks happy. You can see his face in that one. If I was Anthony Mason and I saw this as a prototype of a card that he could potentially be on, and then they showed him that one with his arm covering his face, I'd be gutted. Totally gutted. Doug West, a guard. His ball handling's 4 out of 5. Running the court, 4.5. Shooting range, 4. Defense, 4.2. His key stat, shooting percent of 51%, established a Minnesota Wolves club record. Interesting. Huh. That was back then. Obviously, it's different times now, but that's the first stack of cards. We've got loads to get through. This has been nearly 20 minutes, so it's been 20 minutes that hopefully hasn't driven you more around the bend and given you a bit of relief. Well, maybe jump on tomorrow with a program, perhaps, or a magazine. I've got somewhere an old article about Tony Kukoc when he's still playing for Split Croatia. So maybe I'll dig that out somewhere along the line. But there's decent pictures in a lot of those as well. Some funny shots. BBL, a lot of them as well, BBL. But then, of course, there's the old... I've only got a couple of old Slam magazines. We could look at those, but maybe not. Right. Thanks very much. Take it easy. We'll speak to you soon.